We are discussing about GATE 1990 ECE paper, and this is second 5 mark question related to electronics is appeared. Read the question. In a semiconductor at room temperature, the intrinsic carrier concentration and resistivity are 1.5 into 10 power 16 per meter cube and 2.2 into 10 power 5 ohm meter respectively. It is converted into extrinsic semiconductor with a doping concentration of 10 power 20 per meter cube, and for the extrinsic semiconductor calculate minority carrier concentration, resistivity, shift in Fermi level due to doping, minority carrier concentration when its temperature is increased to a value at which intrinsic carrier concentration becomes doubles. Assume that the mobility of majority and minority carriers are same and KT is equal to 26 milli electron volts at room temperature. Okay. So read the question. It is given as intrinsic semiconductor at first, later with the help of doping it is converted into extrinsic semiconductor. You may assume it is n-type or p-type. Okay. Next, you are calculating minority carrier concentration for the given doping. Next, calculating the resistivity. Next, what will be the shift in Fermi level because of the doping? And the last one is nothing but what will be the value of minority carrier concentration if temperature increases such that Ni gets doubled. Okay, so these 4 points you are going to calculate. We will see how to solve this one. So the given information is given at room temperature, that is 300 degree Kelvin. At room temperature, Ni value is given for intrinsic semiconductor. Ni is nothing but intrinsic carrier concentration, 1.5 into 10 power 16 per meter cube. Next, resistivity of intrinsic semiconductor, rho I, 2 into 10 power 5. Ohm meter. Okay. And given that one mu n is equal to mu p, mobility of electrons and holes are given same. Next, doping concentration. So doping concentration will convert intrinsic into extrinsic. So for simplicity we are assuming that one, assume n-type semiconductor. Then we are going with doping concentration can be treated as ND now, that is nothing but 10 power 20 per meter cube. This is given. Okay. Now, first thing we are going to calculate A. We are calculating first A, that is minority carrier concentration. Always for the given majority carrier concentration, you can calculate minority carrier concentration with the help of mass action law. So, using mass action law. Using mass action law. Mass action law states that one, product of total positive charge and total negative charge is always equal to square of intrinsic carrier concentration under thermal equilibrium. So mass action law says that one, under thermal equilibrium, product of total positive charge and total negative charge, that is N into P, is always equal to square of intrinsic carrier concentration, so Ni square. Here for N type we can write it as Nn multiplied by Pn is equal to Ni square. Nn is approximately equal to doping concentration and Pn is nothing but minority carriers in n-type. So Pn can be written as Ni square divided by Nd. So Pn is equal to Ni square is 1.5 into 10 power 16 whole square divided by 10 power 20. Per meter cube, both are in the same dimensions, so no need to change, all will be in the same dimensions, so that Pn holes in n-type, which are nothing but minority carriers. 1.5 whole square is nothing but 2.5, and 10 power 16 into 2 is nothing but 10 power 32 minus 10 power 20. So it will be 10 power 12 holes, that is minority carriers per meter cube. This many number of minority carriers will be present. Okay. And second bit we are calculating resistivity after doping. Resistivity after doping is nothing but B. We are calculating it. We will go with different color. B. Resistivity after doping is nothing but rho is resistivity of n type, because we are assuming it as n type. Rho n is nothing but 1 by sigma n. That is, resistivity is reciprocal of conductivity. We can write it as conductivity of n type semiconductor is approximately equal to 1 by nn into q into mu n. Okay. So this is mu n plus p n into q into mu p, we can write. So rho n can be written as approximately equal to, since n type is nothing but majority carriers are going to be more compared to minority carriers, it can be approximated as nn into q into mu n. We can neglect this term. Pn into q into mu p can be neglected. So whereas nn is nothing but majority carriers, that will be treated as nd into q into mu n. So to calculate rho n, what we require is nothing but three parameters, nd, q and mu n. Nd value is known, that is 10 power 20 per meter cube, and q is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, whereas mu n value is not given. So we must calculate the mobility of electrons. So if we calculate, if mu n is known, then only you can calculate rho n. So make it as equation 1. Okay. So how to calculate mu n? Mu n can be calculated from intrinsic resistivity. What was given is intrinsic resistivity rho I is given. Rho I is nothing but 1 by sigma I. Sigma I of semiconductor, that is intrinsic semiconductor conductivity, is ni into q into mu n plus mu p. So since it is given, mu n is equal to mu p, okay, so we can write it as ni into q into 2 times of mu n. So from this one, we can write it as mu n is equal to 1 by 2 times of ni into q into rho I. This you can write. Ni value is known, 1.5 into 10 power 16 per meter cube, and q is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Rho I is given as 2 into 10 power 5, and if you substitute all those values, okay, what you are getting is 0.001 meter square per volt second. Meter square per volt second you will get. So here I am writing it again, 0.001 meter square per volt second. This one you will get. So this is mu n value, and it must be in meters only. Remember that one, dimension should be same. So after knowing mu n value, substitute mu n in equation 1. So from that one you can calculate rho n. Rho n is going to be treated as, after substituting the values, 60 ohm meters you will get. This is rho n value. Next we are calculating the shift in Fermi level, C value. Shift in Fermi level with respect to intrinsic Fermi level. that can be written as EFN, that is Fermi level of n-type minus Fermi level of intrinsic semiconductor is equal to, this is EFN minus EFI is nothing but relative difference between intrinsic Fermi level and Fermi level of n-type semiconductor. This can be written as KT, natural logarithm of ND divided by NI. KT is given as 26 milli electron volts and we are writing it as 0.026 volts. Electron milli we are removing, it is electron volts into natural logarithm of ND is 10 power 20 divided by NI 1.5 into 10 power 16. So the value of this one, it is going to be equal to 0.228 electron volts. So that is nothing but Fermi level will move towards conduction band by 0.228 electron volts from intrinsic Fermi level. This is the meaning. Next, D. As temperature increases, given as temperature increases, Ni doubled. Ni doubled is nothing but, so assume Ni new value is nothing but 2 times of Ni previous. So 2 into 1.5 into 10 power 16. So it will become 3 into 10 power 16 per meter cube. This is the new value of Ni. So from mass action law, now we are going to calculate minority carriers of N type. So from mass action law, we can write product of, that is Pn is equal to Ni, here it is Ni nu whole square divided by Nd. So Ni nu is nothing but 3 into 10 power 16 whole square divided by 10 power 20. So 3 square is 19, 9 divided by 10 power 12, 9 into 10 power 12 minority carriers per meter cube will be present. If temperature increases, at that time minority carriers will increases and value is equal to 9 into 10 power 12 per meter cube. So these are the four answers. Thank you.